Jesus Christ! Only me gets chased by crazy mass maniacs! Oh, man, come on, give me a break! Who are you, man?
This is the season to be spooky, homie!
Boop! What the twist!
My fire's burning bright, pumpkin faces in the night. I remember Halloween!
Purple Rain.
No.
Sign of the Times.
Definitely not.
The Batman soundtrack.
Throw it.
Happy Halloween, freaks and geeks! It is October 31st, the night we waited for all year.
The best year ever!
Here it is, guys, the final episode of Halloween Havoc 2018. I am the old ghoul.
And I'm Rocco.
Now, I had a hard time thinking about what movie I wanted to finish on for Halloween, because I expanded this whole month to include those quick kill review videos that I never planned on doing. So as I started to think, what movie did I want to talk about?
And that movie being?
Halloween 3, Season of the Witch. I love this movie. Have you ever even seen this?
I feel like I have, but I honestly don't remember a damn thing about it, so I'm just going to go ahead and say it now.
Halloween 3, we are losing our light. Look at this, guys. Alright, I think we're gonna have to change locations from the graveyard to someplace else to get into the Halloween treats. We're in the car!
Where else would you find us?
Halloween 3! He's never seen it! Ever!
At least, I'm like 99.9% sure. Okay. No, I have not seen it.
Alright, imagine a movie, right? With that pure 80s style filmmaking. A really bizarre shot out there, you can only write it in the 80s type of script. Then throw in Tom Atkins from Night of the Creeps and his mustache. Everything works about this movie, but guess what didn't work? They took Michael Myers out and called it Halloween 3. Have you ever actually heard the reasoning why it's not a Michael Myers movie?
Actually, no, I don't think I have.
Well, what it was, I'm sure a lot of you have heard this story 100 times, so I'll just hit the high points here. What had happened was, John Carpenter didn't even want to do Halloween 2 at all. The studio kind of made him because it was like contractual and he wanted to make other movies, so he made it. So they said, let's make Halloween 3. He said, I don't want to put Michael Myers in it, I want to make a different Halloween movie every year with an original story. Okay. Kind of like how American Horror Story does it now. So basically what John wanted to do was turn Halloween into an anthology series. It came out, audiences despised it. I mean, it's a really weird, quirky movie to begin with, but they hated the fact that Michael Myers wasn't in it.
I was gonna say, to be fair, you are taking out one of the big icons that made Halloween. Halloween.
See, the weird thing is, at the time, back then, there was no internet, right? Whereas, like, now, before a movie comes out, we know everything about it that there could possibly be. Back then, trailers were a little bit misleading. So when people saw the trailer for Halloween 3, Season of the Witch, they really thought it was a Michael Myers movie. So when they saw that he wasn't in there, they got pissed. They got actually genuinely upset.
So real quick, though, can you just nutshell Halloween 3 for me?
I can, right? It's like the classic story I think Goosebumps did. There's been a million variations where your Halloween mask somehow takes over you. In this one, a warlock, right, who feels that the Halloween season, the season of the witch itself, Samhain, has been taken over and commercialized. So he wants to set it right. So this warlock owns a toy company who makes these masks, and the company's called Silver Shamrock. When you put the masks on, okay, there's a little button on the back. Now, there's television commercials wanting to sell you the masks, and they're talking about this big giveaway come Halloween night. So everybody gather around the TV. Oh, it's funny enough, too, because the big giveaway is right after Halloween, the original movie plays. The Jamie Lee Curtis actual movie. Like, during the movie, you'll see on the TV set that they're running commercials for Halloween that's going to be on Halloween night.
All right, that's pretty nifty, though.
It is, though.
I'm not going to lie. That's a nice
ahead of its game. Real quick, what happens is, so all the kids start buying the masks, the commercials are running like crazy. Now, Tom Atkins is a doctor, he comes across some weird things that are happening with some people who had escaped the Silver Shamrock factory, okay? So he gets wrapped up with this girl who's looking for her father. He beds her in 1 second, which is crazy, because it's almost like they like meet, and 2 seconds later he's like, should I sleep in the other room? She's like, you don't have to. Boom, he's all over her! Like, it's
Only the 80s.
I mean, it's lightning fast. So anyway, so Tom and Hyde gets in the girl. They find the whole thing, right? They go to the factory. They find out about the warlock. The warlock captures him. He says, at 9 o'clock. Oh, it's the guy from RoboCop. The guy who runs OCP is the warlock in Halloween 3.
Oh, that's so sick.
Like,
oh,
that's right. Tonight at 9. All of these children's heads will explode into snakes and spiders. And he does this test thing, right? Where he shows Sam Atkins a room of this family. And he does it to the kid in the mask. And the kid's face melts in the mask and spiders and snakes come out. And then, like, the snakes that come out of the mask attack the parents. And, like, the parents wind up, like, dying, dude. And
that's hardcore. Holy hell.
It is. It actually, well, see, it's not, like, horrific. See, this is the weird thing. Halloween's a slasher movie.
Right.
This is a supernatural movie, is what this is. You know what I mean? So, basically, in the end, I really don't want to give it away, but it ain't a 100% happy ending here. Like, I'm going to say that. That, tell me how bizarre that sounds. You don't even throw in the fact that the warlock has robots. He's got robots, guys, right? His whole army.
Well, to be fair, it is the guy from RoboCop, right?
But no, for real. But tell me that doesn't sound insane.
That sounds wild. I you know what? I'm gonna go home and watch it. Because that's how I do Halloween, is I scare myself to death.
Well, the one reason why I wanted to talk about this movie is, when it came out, it was an utter failure. Complete collapse. Failure made no money. It almost doomed the franchise. They had to bring Michael Myers back, dooming us to 4, 5, 6, H2O, Resurrection, 2 Rob Zombies until they got it right, finally. If Halloween 3 had been a hit, we never would have gotten another Michael Myers movie. We would have just had 1 and 2. But Halloween 3 over the past couple years has really, because of the nostalgia of He-Man, the 80s, Transformers, the Goonies, right? People started delving into all the 80s movies that are out there. And people started to realize, hey, this one Halloween movie is so 80s'd out, so funny, that if you just look at it as truly what it is, it's a standalone. Even the writer took his name off of it, and he didn't like the way that they were horrifying it. Mm-hmm. He was like, we should just call it Season of the Witch. And ditch the Halloween 3 thing entirely and just make this sick-ass Tom Atkins horror supernatural movie. Studio said, nope. People need to have a name so they know what to do, and all it did was backfire in their face,
you
man.
You could have just went with Season of the Witch. Okay.
Well, don't you like different sometimes? Don't you prefer when something doesn't retread the same thing? Think about how bold that is, though. To ditch your franchise, keep the title, and try to give something to people that would be a yearly, every year on Halloween, they were going to do this. Do you think how sick that was? You're guaranteed a Halloween movie. Every year it's going to be different, made by the same team. It's like they finally got it with American Horror Story. But I mean, yo, back then, dude, John Carpenter, dude, like, John did not like the reception. So do this. I know a lot of people have seen this movie in my age bracket because it was always on TV, but you might not have paid attention to it, or you might have watched it when you were younger. Go back and watch it again now. This is Halloween! Scary.
Hey, next year, can you actually do a review on one of my movies? Please? Oh my god!